Okay, everybody, welcome to today's travel challenge segment. And I'm super excited. We have a phenomenal guest, Anna Frumkin, here with us today. And Anna's actually a holistic nutrition and wellness counselor. She's based out of San Francisco. And she is actually the owner of Nourish with Anna, which I really love her overall approach because she works with clients on health issues ranging from weight gain, fatigue, low energy, crash dieting, food confusion, which I think is a big thing that we're struggling with these days, digestive issues, blood sugar, autoimmune disease, or conditions. And she works with them remotely all over the world. So if you don't live in the San Francisco area, she can still work with you that way. And so I really like how her approach is based on science, mindfulness, and compassion, because there's so much more to nutrition than just eating the right foods, but so much of that is just the whole overall aspect. So I'm really excited to have you here with us, Anna. And I just have a couple questions for you that we're gonna go over quickly. So thank you so much for joining us. Can you first just tell us a little bit about how long you've been pursuing your passion and your business and what really drives you in your Nourish with Anna?
Well, I just wanna thank you so much for having me. This is such a joy. I love, you know, following you on social media as well. So I've been a nutritionist since 2014 and have really been, it's really been a lifelong passion for me when it comes to helping individuals and crash dieting, heal from digestive issues, and really end burnout. This all really stemmed from why I went to nutrition school, and this was really because I had been, you know, years on crash diets and had digestive issues and had adrenal fatigue, lots of different burnout there as well. So, you know, my mission is to really help individuals make peace with their plate, really teach intuitive eating, and really bring in these wonderful mindfulness practices. When it comes to creating transformation, I really believe it takes three pillars, and that's whole food nutrition, mindset, and lifestyle. So I really help empower my clients understand that this isn't another diet they're going on, right? This is really about, again, making peace with their plate, becoming their own nutritionist, empowering them with sound science that I received. And I feel like once we get all of that taken care of, you know, then after a couple months when our time is, you know, done working together, they really understand the connection there and they don't feel the need to, you know, go on another crash diet.
Yes, awesome. We were just joking before we started recording that I don't believe in the word diet because it starts with die.
Like, yeah.
Dieting cannot be, right?
Yeah, exactly. And I was saying, I say the exact same thing to my clients. I'm like, do you really want to go on a diet? Who wants to do
that? Yeah. Let's talk about happy eating and all of the things combined together.
Yeah.
And this week we're talking about travel and, you know, it's one thing to have healthy nutrition and everything at home. We've got your routine in place. But when you're on the road, especially sometimes with little ones or other people, we want to really look at how we can stay safe. Mm-hmm. So what are general rules when you're traveling of food safety while you're out and about? Are there certain foods that we should avoid, or is there a general rule of thumb? Are there certain places that you recommend people try new foods? Because that's part of the experience too when you're traveling, is to try some of the new foods. Like, give us your top three tips as far as traveling safely with the food.
Yes. So I love to travel, and I hope all of you like to travel as well. But we can't talk about traveling without first talking about H2O, okay? We need to be super mindful when it comes to water, when it comes to tap water, you know, as well as making sure we're getting in filtered water when we're traveling to different countries. You know, in many developing countries, water can be contaminated with bacteria, with parasites. So making sure to drink bottled water, or even, you know, putting water for 3 minutes and boiling it is what's recommended when you're traveling to different countries. Also being mindful of raw veggies and fruits. These could also be rinsed with water that has, you know, been contaminated. So making sure to eat foods that are cooked, right? Making sure to get in really good fruits and veggies that have been rinsed with safe water. When it comes to other foods that we want to be mindful of when we're traveling, we want to be mindful of raw and uncooked meats, poultry, seafood, eggs. We also want to be mindful of unpasteurized milk products, prepared foods that have been left unrefrigerated, say that five times fast, for several hours, you know, especially if we're at like a buffet, something like this, we just want to be careful about how long food has been left out. Again, when it comes to the eggs, the meat, the dairy. And we also want to be mindful of street vendors and where that food is coming from as well. When it comes to safe foods that we want to include, this should be thoroughly cooked veggies, right? Fruits that have a really thick skin. So think your citrus fruits, oranges, bananas, melons that have been washed in safe water. Thoroughly cooked meat, again, is vital. Poultry, eggs, fish, dairy products that have been pasteurized are also going to be safer as well.
Awesome. Yes, I love that. Definitely the water is one of the big things that I think of too. We have another home in Mexico where we travel a lot, and just having to, it's such a weird transition that all of the produce that I wash has to be washed with the filtered water.
Yes.
And it's a process, but so important, because the last thing you want while you're traveling is to get sick from unsafe foods. And we're actually just a couple of weeks ago at an all-inclusive resort for a few days while we were doing some remodeling. And again, with the buffet food, there's a couple of things where I'd go like, oh, I don't know how to wait for the fresh platter to be brought out. So thank you so much for that. I think that this is really, really helpful.
Yeah.
And then just remind us again, Anna, where our audience can find you. We've loved your tips, and I just really love connecting with you. So where we can find you at, and obviously we'll put the handle where people can connect with you at the bottom of this video.
So you can all find me at nourishwithanna.com. You can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, and social media handles at nourishwithanna. And I offer all of my clients a free 30-minute nutrition consultation to better get to know your health and wellness goals. So be sure to mention this interview for some extra bonuses as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Anna. And to everybody out there, wish you such a safe and happy traveling.
Yes.
Next time.
See ya.